Fibromyalgia is a chronic pain disorder, and if you had to really simplify it, it's a brain pain disorder. Pain is an experience. We oftentimes talk about pain as if it's a very discrete thing, that it's just you touch something that's, you know, on fire and it makes pain. Pain is a part of what we call somatosensation. What is somatosensation? It involves a variety of different experiences that we get through the neurons in our peripheral nervous system. Some of them include pressure, some of them include vibration, some of them include temperature. But what we know about pain is that it activates a specific type of neuron called a nociceptor that goes to the spinal cord and then to the brain. What we know from research is that fibromyalgia is caused by an overactive central nervous system when it comes to how your brain and your spinal cord process pain. The way I like to describe fibromyalgia to patients is if you think of your brain as a volume control knob and your brain as having the ability to amplify or dampen pain, just like you have the ability to turn up a volume on a radio or turn it down. When you think about fibromyalgia, what happens is over time, the brain volume knob gets turned up quite a bit, and your body has a hard time turning it down. And so when we talk about the best ways to treat fibromyalgia, they're doing things that help turn the volume knob down. So a pain psychologist can do things such as cognitive behavioral therapy or acceptance and commitment therapy to help patients have a greater knowledge of how they think about pain and behave about pain and make changes to be able to manage, cope, and treat their pain better using their basically their own brain, having that power within themselves to address it.